Hey, what's up, guys? Today we're going to be talking about Astro 3.3 that was just released. The main feature really is a picture component, which we can look into. So let's open up a terminal here, create Astro at latest. We're going to name it testing 3.3, include sample files, include dependencies. Oh, that light's really bright, dude. I'm blown out. I noticed in that last video, it was like white. A little better. All right, so we're working with a new picture component, which is different than the image component. The picture component, we're going to figure out actually what that is together. All right, let's verify actually that our install is 3.3. Yes, it is. Perfect. You can verify that in the package.json if you're wondering. In 3.0, we removed our old image integration, and along with some existing features we know you were using, we decided to build back better with a stronger image story that was only getting started. First party. So if you want, they link the RFC and the pull request thread. So it says the image component is great for a single image. However, it doesn't answer some of the common needs for the web, such as fallback formats and responsive images. The new experimental picture component can be used to generate a picture element with multiple source elements. All right, let's try it out. When I do these small tests like this, I like to do it right on the index page. And I'm just going to get rid of the junk in the main here. And we got to find an image. And we are on localhost 4321 with Astro 3.0 or later. Here is our image. I'm not sure what we're supposed to be looking for. All right, it's an image. It is rendered as an SVG. The above code will generate the following HTML. So it should be rendered in multiple formats. And I do see that. We should get a PNG. Let's just do a screenshot. That looks weird because it's a screenshot of what we're doing right next to it. But we do see it has generated a WebP and AVIF image. So these formats did render, which is cool, which is great. So it's optimizing the PNG. It's transferring it into a more optimized image format. In addition to the picture element, two new properties have been added. So let's try these ones. So instead of format, we're going to use width, which is myImage.width divided by 2. And then the densities, these properties can be used to generate a source set attribute, either based on the absolute width in pixels or pixel density descriptors. Let's try this. Let's save it and see what happens. Okay, so we have a source set image. Oh, okay, so it's giving me the multiple sizes. So like I always think of the retina images for high resolution screens. When you go to export an image in Photoshop, it will allow you to build a 1x, 2x, 4x image. So that's what this is doing. And then up here, it automatically did a WebP, which I think is just Astro doing optimized image formats, just because that's the thing to do. It's supposed to be fast, so that's what it's doing. A few small other things. Syntax highlighting. They changed syntax highlighter library. Small change, but it could be broken if your code is not formatted correctly, and they give the example on the release notes here. Okay, so they have a small change to package provenance. If you're not sure what that means, basically, it means that NPM is using a security measure to ensure that when you download a package from NPM, it's like a legitimate NPM package and not something fishy. And there are additional bug fixes and quality of life improvements in the release notes. Let's see if there's anything of note in here. Here's the syntax highlighting. Here's the image stuff, the picture component. Not much else. So yeah, I hope this was helpful. If you saw the release notes and you're curious on what the picture component looks like and some of the other releases or changes in Astro. I hope this answered some questions. Feel free to leave a comment if you have any further questions. I hope this was helpful. Thank you so much for watching. Like and subscribe. Thank you so much. Have a great weekend, and I'll talk to you later.